Hello everyone, welcome to Princeton Air, and today in this lecture we are going to discuss about the assertion and reason based question. Okay, and it may be the last lecture of this chapter, and afterwards we will move on to the next chapter. Clear? So here that is the today's objective, assertion and reason based questions. Clear? Now first question is assertion. Now, firstly, I just want to tell you the trick how to solve these type of questions. See, simple trick is there. I just want to explain this here. In assertion reason based question, on the basis of board level, okay, academic levels, not of I'm not telling about the that competition based assertion reasons. I'm just telling about the board based. So here there will be the four options. There will be four options, and that option you that will be same everywhere. Clear? So option A will be, you have to learn in this way, assertion reason equal to, option B assertion reason equals to, option C assertion reason equals to, option D assertion reason equals to. Clear? Now if assertion is correct, if assertion is correct and reason is also correct, and reason is the correct explanation of assertion, means if you are getting these three statements correct, then option A will be picked up. If assertion is correct, reason is also correct, but reason is not the correct explanation of assertion, then you have to pick out the option B. If assertion is correct, but reason is incorrect, if reason is incorrect means it will be incorrect explanation for assertion, and in that case option C will be picked out. Clear? And if you are seeing the first statement which is assertion and it is incorrect, no need to read the option second or statement second, that is of reason. If assertion is incorrect, then reason should be incorrect, and also that the relation is incorrect. So option D should be picked up. Clear? Means there are so many tricks here. Whenever you will get only assertion correct, so answer will be from first three options. Clear? That will be wrong. And in that case, if reason is correct, so option 2 will be there. Means the two choices are there, no? So you have to pick any one. And if there is no relation between, if there is a relation between assertion and reason, then option A will be correct. And if no relation is there, then option B will be the correct explanation. Clear? Now we will do some question, and in that way you can just learn the trick how to apply this. Now see this assertion: solids have definite volume and definite shape. Okay, solids have definite volume and shape. Clear? Next is reason. In solids, the constituent particles are very close to each other and there is not much freedom of movement. So tell me, first statement is correct or not? Means assertion is correct or not? Okay, tell me there. Try to do that question and tell me assertion is correct or not. Solids have definite volume and definite shape. It is correct. So like in this way you can write A plus B, A plus R, assertion reason equal to. So if assertion is correct, here assertion is correct. Clear? Next, reason. In solids the constituent particles are very close to each other and there is not so much freedom of movement. Clear? Means the particles are close to each other and they cannot move apart. That's why you can say the volume is fixed and shape is fixed. So reason is also correct, and also that there is a relation between these two statements, so it is also correct here. So we got three correct, means option A will be picked out here. Clear? We can do one more question. See this one. Assertion on heating, assertion that is on heating a solid usually changes to liquid, and the liquid on further heating changes to gaseous state. Assertion reason equals to, yeah, assertion is correct here. Obviously, whenever you are heating solid particles, they are changes into liquid, and liquid on further heating, they are changes into gaseous state. Okay. Arrangement of constituent particles is different in solids, liquids and gaseous states. Yeah, it is also correct. But in case of the that is a just difference between the solid, liquid, gas on the basis of constituent particles, but that is not related to that statement. Okay, so means relation is not correct. So answer should be, tell me the answer should be option B here. So if you are getting 2 right, means option B. If you are getting 3 right, option A. If you are getting 1 right, option C. If you are getting no any assertion and reason right, means option D will be the correct answer. Next, assertion is the components of homogeneous mixture cannot be separated by using the physical methods. Okay. So, components of homogeneous mixtures cannot be separated using physical methods. Mixtures can be separated. Chemical compounds, their components cannot be separated. So, assertion and reason. Here, assertion is wrong. First statement is wrong. No need to read that second statement. So, it will be. Reason will also be wrong and their relation will also be wrong. Answer D will be there. Okay. Answer D will be there. One more we can do. Next question. Assertion. Elements and compounds are the examples of pure substances. Elements and compounds are the examples of pure substances. So, let me understand that. Elements and compounds are the examples of pure substances. It is right here. Pure substances are divided into 2 categories, elements and compounds. So, that are the examples. Okay. Reason. The properties of compound and are different from those of its constituent particles. See, the properties of compounds are different from the those of constituent particles. Is it right or wrong? Yeah, it is also right, but there is no relation between these two statements. So, the relation is wrong here. So, option B will be taken it out. Now, from next question onwards, I will give you 10 seconds to solve that question. In within 5 seconds, it should be done. Yeah. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now assertion is the mass of substance is a constant, whereas weight may vary from one place to another. Assertion and reason. Yes, assertion is right because the mass is a constant quantity, but weight can be changed. Okay. So now reason. Mass of a substance is the amount of matter present in it, while weight is the force exerted by the gravity on the object. Yeah, reason is also correct, and also they are making the relationship between them. Why mass is constant? Because it is an amount of substance or amount of matter present in it. Okay, and why weight is varying? Because the gravity can be changed from one place to another place. So, the relation between them is also right here. Yes or no? So, option A will be picked out. Clear? नेक्स्ट असर्शन, टेम्परेचर बिलो 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस आर पॉसिबल इन सेल्सियस स्केल बट इन केल्विन स्केल नेगेटिव टेम्परेचर इज नॉट पॉसिबल. रिमेंबर दैट इन द स्केल टेम्परेचर स्केल्स व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड देयर. Remember that degree Celsius 0 to 100, degree Fahrenheit 32 to 218, and that's of 273 to 373 for Kelvin. Now it cannot be negative. These two can be negative. Now you can see assertion that temperature below 0 degrees Celsius are possible. Yeah, it is possible. But Kelvin is negative, is temperature not possible. Now reason. Assertion and reason. Assertion is correct here. The Kelvin scale is related to Celsius scale as follows. That is the relation between these two. Okay. So in that way you can say it can be negative. Celsius can be negative here. Yes or no? Yes or no? But can you check it out? Is that relation is correct? No, it is not correct. Actually, the relation is degree Celsius plus 273.15. Here it is written negative sign. Okay. So now the reason is incorrect here. So only one correction is there, means that option C will be the right here. Okay. Now next question is assertion. Scientific notation for the number 100 is expressed as 1 into 10 raised power 2. Okay. Yeah, that is correct here. That is correct. Assertion is correct. Reason, the number 1 into 10 raised power 2 has two significant figures. How is it possible? How is it possible? Only one number is there, no? So reason is correct, incorrect here. So it is also incorrect. Option C will be the right. Next. So try to do that question yourself first. Assertion, matter can neither be created nor be destroyed. And the reason is this is law of definite proportion. Is that true? Are you kidding? Matter can neither be created nor be destroyed. It is for the statement of law of conservation of mass. Okay. So, second statement, assertion and reason. Assertion is correct, reason is incorrect, it is the relation is also incorrect. So, option C will be the right here. Next, assertion, 12 parts by mass of carbon in carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. Molecules combined with 16 and 32 parts by mass of oxygen. So, assertion is like in this way. Reason, given compound always contains exactly the same proportion of elements by weight. Now, try to do that question yourself first. So, let me give you the answer. See. In carbon monoxide, 12 gram carbon is attached to the 16 gram of oxygen. In carbon dioxide, 12 gram is attached to the 32 gram. So, what they are saying, 12 parts of by mass of carbon, you can see 12 parts. In carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide molecules, the combined with 16 and 32 parts by mass of oxygen. That is correct. So assertion is correct here. Reason: a given compound always contains exactly the same proportion of elements by weight. Yeah, they are same here. Okay, so reason is also correct, and that both are having same equal statements, or you can say the relation, same relation. So answer should be A here. If three correct are there, so answer should be A here. Now try to do that question. One atomic mass unit is defined as 1/12 of the mass of one carbon 12 atom. Reason: carbon 12 isotope is most abundant isotope of carbon and has been chosen as standard. Now try to do that question. So let me give you the answer. Assertion and reason. Here one atom of mass unit is defined as 1/12 of that mass of one carbon 12 atom. Okay, so assertion is right here. One atomic mass unit is like in this way, means mass of 1/12 of carbon 12 atom. Okay, reason: carbon 12 isotope is most abundant isotope. Okay, most abundant isotope of carbon. Yeah, that is right, that is right, and has been chosen as a standard. Okay, that is also correct. Reason is also correct. We can say, okay, we can say that reason is also correct, but that is not the reason behind the behind picking out the carbon 12 as a standard isotope for one atomic mass unit. That is not the correct you can say that statement, or you can say explanation for the assertion. So that is wrong here, and in that way we have to pick out option B. Okay, now move to next question. Try to do that question yourself. Okay, now you are thinking that sir is saying so many times, you know, okay at the end of the sentence. Actually it is an habit. So what should I do? Next, assertion: one mole of a substance always contains the same number of entities, no matter what the substance may be. Reason: one mole is the amount of substance that contains as many particles or entities as there are the atoms in exactly 12 gram of carbon 12 isotope. Now see this assertion: one mole of substance always contain the same number of entities. Okay, as we know that one mole of substance are containing same number of entities, that is Avogadro's number, no matter what the substance may be. Yeah, that is correct here. Okay, that is correct here. Afterwards, reason: one mole of the is the amount of substance that contains as many particles or entities as there are atoms in exactly 12 gram of carbon 12 isotope. That is also correct. Assertion is correct, reason is correct. So both are related to the number of particles. Statements are interrelated here. So reason is also correct. Option A will be picked out. That are the simple questions, no? Next, yeah, try to do that question yourself first. I will not speak that statement first. You are getting only 10 seconds to do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So check it out. Assertion: molecular formula shows that exact number of different types of atoms present in the molecules of a compound. Yeah. Assertion, reason. Assertion is correct here. Now, reason. Molecular formula can be obtained by directly from empirical formula, which represents the simplest whole number ratio of various atoms present in the compound. Statement is correct, but we can't pick out the molecular formula from empirical formula directly. For that, we should know the molecular mass. Okay. So, now reason is incorrect here, and here both relation will be incorrect. So, answer should be C. Clear? Next, try to do that question yourself. I'll be aside here. Now, done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, done? Yeah. So, now see this. Whenever I'm giving you time, no, you just pause the video. And next time, I will not give you so much time to solve the question. Whenever I'm saying to solve that question, just pause that video during that time. Now, next is assertion that the reactant which is represented in larger amount limits the amount of product former is called limiting reagent. Okay, means that reactant which is limiting the amount of product that will limits the that are limiting the amount of product and which are in limited quantity in the given reaction mixture, that are considered to be as limiting reagent. Clear? Reason. Now, reason we have to tell, amount of product formed does not depend upon the amount of reactant taken. Okay, let me check once. Assertion, the reactant which present in larger quantity, larger amount, no, which is present in lesser amount, that are considered to be a limiting reagent. So, here assertion and reason, assertion is wrong. So, reason will also be wrong, the relation will also be wrong. So, option D will be the correct here. I didn't see that larger here. Okay. So, be conscious during this reading the statement. Clear? Now, next. 14th question. Try to do that question yourself first. Okay, so done. Yes or no? Check this. Assertion. Molarity of a solution does not depend upon the temperature, whereas molality depends. It is just opposite, no? It seems to be opposite. Molarity depends upon the temperature. Molality doesn't depend upon the temperature. That you have to memorize, okay? Molality depends upon the mass, and mass is not depending on the temperature. Mass is constant quantity in that way. But molarity depends upon the volume, and which can vary with change in temperature, okay? So, molarity depends upon temperature, molality does not depend on the temperature. So, that statement is just reverse. So, assertion, reason, here assertion is wrong, otherwise in that way reason is also wrong. So, relation will also be wrong. Option D will be the correct here, okay? Next is the last question maybe. So, try to do that question yourself first. Yeah. Done? Done. Huh? So, now, assertion. In laboratory, a solution of a desired concentration is prepared by diluting a stock of solution. Diluting a stock solution. Okay. Clear? Now, reason is the stock solution is a solution of higher concentration. Clear? So, that is also right. Assertion is also right here. Reason is also right here. because Stokes solution is also having the higher concentration, and these both are interrelated with each other. So interrelation is also there, means three correct, option A will be the correct here. Okay. Now, so that is the end of this lecture and chapter also. So I hope you learn so much things from the assertion reason part, because that is most important part of your syllabus base, and also in your further side competitive exams. So at the end of this video, I would say keep studying, keep motivated, and stay at home, and be at home. Okay, so try to do that questions once again, once again you can do that question, that type of question, from any other book you can follow. Okay, from internet sources you can pick out any other questions. Clear? So till then, keep studying, keep motivated. Thank you.